For some of us, we are lucky enough to live a life full of promise and opportunities. We can afford to dream, and sometimes our dreams come true. Yet for millions in the developing world, specifically here in Kenya, have their dreams curtailed from the moment they are born, all because of a congenital deformity, commonly known as cleft lip and palate. In some communities, children born with this condition are disgraced, isolated, rejected, and in extreme cases, killed. These children live in shame and have difficulty in eating, breathing, and speaking. Many of them do not even attend school because of the stigma associated. And yet, cleft can be repaired, and the surgery is simple and transformation immediate. I have partnered with Smile Train, an organization that trains local doctors to perform correctional surgeries on cleft and palate in their communities. With Smile Train partnership, we help these communities access the surgeries free of charge. This initiative not only restores smiles, but also enriches and transforms lives.
Amazing, amazing work, ladies and gentlemen, by Miss World Kenya, Miss Roshanara Ebrahim. Welcome to She Power.
Thank you so much.
I mean, what we've just seen in the videos is truly amazing. And I think what's going through everybody's minds is how do you do it?
It is something I always wanted to do, matter of factly. For as long as I can remember, this has always been a place I wanted to be. Mm-hmm. I'm also a law student. So for me, Miss World is beauty with a purpose. It's not only fashion, it's not only beauty, it's actually making something of yourself and making a change in the world using the title.
Amazing. A lawyer and Miss World Kenya. Are you able to juggle between the two? I mean, how do the two fields come together?
Well, law obviously stimulates me intellectually, which I can't live without. And well, modeling is fun. It's a lot of adrenaline. It's like acting, actually. You become a whole other person. It's a hobby. It's something I do on the side that I've actually become quite successful with.
Amazing, amazing work there. And as we delve further into your modeling career, how did you get to Miss World? How has the journey been thus far?
It's been a very, very interesting journey so far. A lot of ups and downs, as usual, with everything you put your mind to doing. It's taught me a lot, definitely. I've been enlightened by a lot of situations I've had to go through. I've had to change my lifestyle. I have to basically be a lot healthier than I used to be. I have to exercise, eat right. Uh-huh. It's no longer about me, it's about Kenya. It's about representing a country, and it's a huge, huge deal. The journey is still going on, actually. I'm still yet to learn. I just got crowned 3 months ago, so it's an ongoing process.
Wonderful, amazing. For the people out there who, you know, would look up to being beauty queens and, you know, getting into it, there's the misperception, you know, that it's all about looking glam and all that. But then here we have a wonderful cause, Smile Train. Maybe you can tell us a little bit more about that.
To add on to what you said, actually, it's not as glamorous as it looks. It's actually a very, very difficult job to do. Like I said, it's not just about the beauty, it's about the purpose more than the beauty, in fact. Yeah. So with Miss World, it's not just about going on stage and looking beautiful. It's an ongoing process that will last a year to determine whether I'm worth it in the end or not. So it's not all glam. It's actually quite very difficult.
Mm-hmm. What does it entail, you know, your day-to-day, maybe to give us a better context?
Okay, so it's actually kind of like an office job with Smile Train. I do a lot of fundraising, which involves corporates, individuals, activation causes, for example, door-to-door campaigns, a lot of poster distribution, a lot of mingling with crowds, you know, so I have to make sure I go for quite a lot of events to be able to get the message out there. So that's
basically it. Yeah. Amazing. Maybe you can tell us a bit more about the Smile Train campaign. I understand it's a global initiative.
Yes.
How did it get to Kenya?
Miss World Kenya is actually collaborating with the Smile Train, which is actually there in Kenya since 2008, to tackle, of course, the problem of children and adults now with the congenital deformity, which is the cleft lip and palate. So yes, it's spread. It's become quite a big institution, I mean an organization, and it's all over the world now, but I'm not really sure about how it came to Kenya, how, you know, what their journey was. Yeah. But what I can say is they're doing a magnificent job and it's working. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So for the many viewers at home who are watching and maybe do not understand, you know, the whole purpose of Smile Train, which is, you know, doing surgeries on cleft lips and palates, maybe you can give us a more deeper explanation or a basic one.
Okay, so cleft lip and palate is a congenital deformity, which means children are born with it. Why exactly it happens, what causes it, is still a matter of discussion. There's no clear reason as to why children are born like that. But it's only a 30-minute surgery to help it go away. And then a child is free for the rest of their lives to smile like any one of us.
Amazing, amazing. And when I was reading up on it is one of the profound things behind it is people don't understand, I mean, what a smile is worth. And exactly. I think that's very important, yes. Especially in your position, you know, as a beauty queen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The social stigma behind it is extremely, extremely heavy because, first of all, the uneducated people around the world, I won't just limit this to Kenyans or Africans, believe that some of these children are demons born in human skin. So we've seen a lot of situations where these babies are actually burnt or killed because their family doesn't want to deal with the stigma. Mm-hmm. You have these children who go to school, no one wants to play with them because they look scary, you know?
Yeah.
No one wants to associate themselves with it. And even today, with where we stand today, you can't have secretaries with the cleft lip or palate because they just don't look the part. Mm-hmm. You can't have beauty queens with the palate because it doesn't look right. And it's not just a cosmetic problem. These people with cleft lip and palate find it difficult to eat. It's very difficult to breathe. Their dental formulas are messed up and it's a very, very difficult life to live. And as a matter of fact, only 1 out of 10 children born live to their first birthday. So it's a very, very serious problem. And it's not just about the social stigma.
All right. So it's not all about, you know, how you look. It's actually...
It's not about how you look.
All right.
But I can say that after the surgery, we've seen a lot of successful results. In fact, during my reign, Miss Siaya, also is a cleft lip... patient. She had her surgery and now she's a beauty queen. Look at that.
That's amazing. That's
it
a success story. And being that you've only been Miss World Kenya for 3 months, maybe you can share with us some of the experiences that you've had being an active ambassador for Smile Train and, you know, actually engaging with this young children and now even grown-ups.
Yeah, the experiences are out of this world. Actually, it's why I'm driven to do what I do, why I wake up every morning and I strive to find these children wherever they are and find treatment for them, try to fundraise to make sure that these surgeries are free because most of them can't afford them. One experience that I've had is actually the oldest patient I've ever seen. She was 90 years old and she came to Smile Train and said, it's time. I don't want to die not knowing what my smile looks like. And she said, I've lived behind, you know, a rock all my life because no one's wanted to talk to me because I scare people. Mm-hmm. And in reality, if you did look at her, it was actually quite a scary sight to see. And it's painful to know that she lived her whole life like that, not being loved by anyone just because of the way she looked. Mm-hmm. And miraculously, even though she had a palate, she was able to survive all those years with difficulty breathing and eating and, you know, and so... We got her on a piki-piki all the way from the village she was at. She mm-hmm. came all the way to Kimilili, which is near Bungoma. Mm-hmm. On her, this is actually quite tragic. On the bike ride there, she had a scarf on and the driver got to see what she looked like and he hit the brakes really hard. She fell off the bike, she fell into a river and he just left her there. So she was brought to hospital. Then we had to get her head stitched because she had injuries on her head, on her ankle. And then finally, after her treatment, we got her cleft repaired and it's beautiful.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a wonderful story.
She's extremely happy.
And I mean, the Boda Boda guy's reaction is just a testimony. I mean, testament to what people actually
exactly.
think. and it's truly sad. And why do you think in the country, given that you're now engaging actively in this project, that we don't have that much awareness on, I mean, it's a 30-minute surgery to fix this condition. Exactly. Why do you think we don't have this information disseminated to the people, you know, in the villages and rural areas?
Yeah, that's probably a problem with the communication outreach. A lot of these people in these rural areas don't have access to TV, internet. And so it's our duty as Kenyans to make sure that we put in that little bit more effort and go there. You know, go look for these people, find them and tell them that it can be helped. Mm-hmm. It's not the end of the world and, you know, their future lies way brighter than it looks now.
Amazing. As Smile Train, how, I mean, the partnership between you and Smile Train, how are you able to reach out to all these cases? And, you know, like if somebody's watching now and they have somebody to, you know, refer to you guys, how does the whole process work?
Okay, so either you can go into the Miss World website, or you can go into the Smile Train website, or you can call me personally on 0715-977526, or go onto my Twitter account, which is Roshanara E254, or Instagram Roshanara_Ebrahim, and I will definitely make sure it happens.
All right, wonderful. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are taking a short break, but when we come back, we'll wind up our conversation on Smile Train with Roshanara and get to learn a few more fun facts about her. Keep it She Power on WTV Kenya. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to She Power. Today with me in studio is Miss World Kenya 2016, Miss Roshanara Ebrahim. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
Now, going back into our conversation, maybe I'd like to highlight 3 months in on the rain. You still have a whole year ahead of you. What are the plans? And I mean, in terms of the Smile Train campaign, what do we expect to see?
A lot of awareness created, for one. A lot of fundraising, hopefully. Mm-hmm. My target is 10 million. Mm-hmm. Lord help me fulfill that wish. But yeah, all in all, like you said, there's not much awareness created down in the rural areas, and that's my number one target. That's what I'd like to do. And also, a lot of mothers with cleft babies don't know how to feed their kids. Okay. And so that's an art on its own that I'd really like to educate the mothers out there. Mm-hmm. About how to feed their kids, and especially because the surgery can't be done before the kids are 3 months old or a certain weight, the feeding process is extremely, extremely important.
All right, maybe you can share with us a little bit about that, the process. I mean, what makes it so technical?
Okay, first of all, as I said earlier, they have problems feeding. Babies with the palate basically are at risk of having a choking situation because their trachea is not protected. Mm-hmm. So usually there's a teaspoon method which we use, because then giving baby bottles as well can be quite tricky because there's no suction. Mm-hmm. And secondly, also hygiene issues. So the teaspoon method is usually the best when it comes to feeding them milk. Mm-hmm. It basically considerably reduces the risk of choking. Mm-hmm. That's one tip.
Good. What areas do you plan on targeting first?
Everything at once. Everything at once. Because I work tirelessly, actually, day in, day out. You can find me at 3 o'clock in the morning writing emails out to potential sponsors. And so it's 1 year where I get to put in my best foot forward. And this is the 1 year where I strive to make the biggest difference. But of course, I have the passion, and so it'll be an ongoing process for hopefully the rest of my life.
Roshanara, and as we wind up this part of our conversation, maybe you can look into your camera and give a piece of advice to all the young ladies out there, you know, who want to be seated where you're seated, who are passionate and still have the brains and the beauty.
For all the girls out there, my advice to you is just believe in yourself. If it's meant to be, it'll come to you, but just always believe in yourself and don't lose your dignity or your self-respect. That's what I have to say. That's the utmost important advice.
Amazing, amazing. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's about that time where we get to have the She Fun Facts. And today our guest is Miss World Kenya 2016, Miss Roshanara Ebrahim. Now, to start us off, what is the first thing you do when you wake up in the morning?
Look at my phone.
Being that you are in the limelight and a public figure, what is the most rude thing anyone has ever said to you, you know, even after being crowned?
So I'll give you two. Okay. The first one was I posted a photo of my Miss World nomination on my Instagram page, and someone posted, "So who's doing her?" And I'm just thinking, what's wrong with men nowadays? Whose business is it? You know? And why ask in such a crude manner? Secondly, gutter press. If you're listening, really get a life and a better paying job, because it's quite irritating for people to brand all beauty queens, whether they're beauty queens with a purpose or good people genuinely who have self-dignity, in the same category as, you know, prostitutes. It's not right. We're an absolutely different kind of women, and we deserve to be respected. And just, you know, putting them in the same category as everyone else is extremely offensive, and these people need to they need to educate themselves. Not all women are the same.
Yes, yeah. Indeed. Strong words there, and I hope the gutter press is listening in. Number three, what is one of your worst pet peeves that people do?
One of my
pet peeves, the most irritating that people do.
Men who sag really low. Okay. I can't stand it.
Okay. All right.
That's very interesting. And the last one, we usually have a tongue twister here to improve our English and she power. Feel okay. free.
Oh my god. Okay. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled pebbles. Uh-huh. Ah, she okay. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. I got it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers.
All right. Amazing. Thank you very much, Roshanara. Thank you for joining us here on She Power.
Big pleasure to be here. This is so much fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is She Power. We have been talking to and having a wonderful conversation with Miss World Kenya 2016, Roshanara Ebrahim. She has been talking to us about herself and also the Smile Train initiative, changing the lives of children and grown-ups alike, putting a smile on their face. So do not take it for granted that you can smile. I've been your host, Linda Kroeger. This is She Power. Keep it WTV Kenya.